thank you for joining us for a brief overview of some key enhancements in the Teamcenter integration for Solid Edge. We'll start with the File Open dialog, where docking panes are now available, enabling users to easily configure the interface to best support specific tasks and data types. The Files of Type filter is also enhanced, enabling users to specify all Solid Edge file types to be returned by a search. A single file type, or a combination of specific file types. You can display a thumbnail preview of individual files that you select, including Solid Edge parts, assemblies, and drawings. Additional panes in the File Open dialog provide access to previously saved searches, revision rules, and download options. These options enable users to specify exactly how an assembly will be opened, for example, whether the latest revision of every part should be referenced, and whether simplified representations of certain parts should be used for better performance. A separate dockable pane is also available to display the properties of your Solid Edge files, very useful when you have a large number of properties to manage. All of these panes can be opened, closed, and docked as needed. Managing large data sets or data with many properties is easier and the possibility of errors is minimized. A pane is also available for active workspace. The contents displayed here can be configured by users. We now type in a part number to the quick search to quickly find and open a specific frame design that we want to work on. Our task is to complete this frame design for a specific customer. We'll use Teamcenter classification to select the correct Solid Edge frame components, and finally, we'll specify occurrence properties describing how these components will be treated to meet the customer's specific requirements. We use the active workspace window that's embedded in Solid Edge to run a wildcard search to find all our files. We then apply a filter in our classification area to find all the frame profiles that we've previously classified. Opening the frame profiles presents the different classes for frame types, such as angle, C-section, square, and round. It also displays the quantity of each of these class types that we have in our database. Selecting the round section class shows that we've added a further classification level for ANSI and DIM standard sections. We select the ANSI class that has 5 sections in it. Filters show the attributes available to select our specific profile. In this example, we choose diameter, and we can select the 2-inch diameter round section that we want to use. This section can now be placed in our active assembly, as with any valid Solid Edge file selected using Active Workspace. The frame command requires that we select our profile through the frame open dialog box, so we copy the section into the frame environment. We select the profile that defines the location of the new frame component, and the round tube section is inserted in the correct location. Our frame design is now complete. Next, we'll show how easy it is to add a component into an existing classification system. We first use Active Workspace to navigate to a 100mm square tube section that we've created in Solid Edge. We then select the Classify command and the correct classification for this component, Frame Profiles, Square Tubing, DIN. We then specify attribute values. In this case, wall thickness of 10 millimeters, a section height of 100 millimeters, and a material. The attributes requested are specific to the specific class of component. We click on Classify to add this section to our classification system. When we review the component in Active Workspace, we can see the complete classification details. Finally, we'll show how we can add occurrence properties in Solid Edge and store this information in Teamcenter so they can be added to a bill of materials. In this example, we want to specify black powder coating on the square tube and blue powder coating on the round tube. The treatment is not specified to the item revision, so it is only applicable to how these components are used in this specific frame assembly. We use the Solid Edge Occurrence Properties dialog to specify black powder coating to the square tube components and blue powder coating to the round tube components. We save the assembly and upload it to Teamcenter. When we do this, we specify the customer using a dynamic list of values type attribute. A dynamic list of values type attribute is easy to configure and can be managed in Teamcenter without needing intervention from an administrator. You can see how the close integration between Solid Edge and Teamcenter speeds the completion of tedious data management tasks, ensuring your data is of the highest quality and minimizes the possibility of errors in downstream processes.